Hi, welcome to the monthly Reddit videos. Sorry, I know I'm a bit late on making this one. I've just been really busy. I've got a lot of things going on in my life and I got a lot of things to plan in my life. Bruh, I don't even think I'm gonna do a 900 sub special at this point. Truthfully, I have recorded a whole ass 900 sub special, but I didn't like it, so I never released. But anyways, Reddit! Aurelius after college. Well, I'm in university, but I think you Americans call it college. But look, I would love to be a teacher one day, but just not for math, bro. I am currently doing a math unit for my university course, and like, how do I say this? I want to do things in a certain way, but then you're expected to do it a whole other way. So I'm constantly losing marks here and there because I didn't do it the way that it's supposed to be done. But it's still the same thing, it's still the same answer, you still get to the same end goal. And then I'm just here like, if the answer is the same at the end, why do I have to do it differently? Shouldn't I be doing it in the way that it suits me? Like, bruh! You see, I'm over here thinking I can't express myself in math now. Where's my right to express myself the way I want to in math? I read your Kevin 11 episode in the Omniverse art style. That's so cool, bro. That's actually really cool. I remember this episode. Yo, you wanna know what I just remembered? You guys remember that episode where young Ben 10 meets old Ben 10 and then Kevin Levin calls him a juvenile delinquent? Whoa, wait.
Not something. Someone.
Bro, I'm like, Ben Tennyson. I never watched this episode personally, but just the idea of young Ben 10 meeting like this age of Ben 10 familiar. And then them being so different from each other. Like, it gives you such a good perspective. It's funny.
Don't make me hurt you, okay?
Like, this is actually the perfect example. This guy is the perfect example of act first, think later. Like, that's what little Ben 10 always was. I love it.
I'm not 11 anymore. I'm not evil. I'm nuanced.
I'm nuanced,
whatever you're trying
bruh.
To pull, Levin, it's not gonna work.
Bruh.
It's hero time.
I'm nuanced. Ooh, that old animation.
Little juvenile delinquent trying to set me on fire?
That's the part I was talking about. Kevin just goes on and picks a fight with Ben. Yeah, anyway, that's just what I wanted to show. Gianja. Yes, very Gianja. Very cute, though. Kitties. Kitties are adorable. You got an adorable kitty. I want to be more than friends. You want to be cousins? Bruh, imagine you mess up so hard that she doesn't friend zone you, she doesn't bro zone you, she cousin zones you. I mean, I'm sure you can make some sort of a joke where you can go to a different country where marrying your cousins is allowed. So you know what? Cuz, smash. No, I'm joking. Ooh, Fatalis in the ring right now, bruh. What's he gonna do? Oh yeah, no, I saw this. Bro, watch Fatalis. He's gonna throw the best snipe you have ever seen. He's gonna go off the ramp and then he's gonna throw the bomb to whoever was first. Yeah, watch. It actually hits. Did you see that? Did you? We're watching that again. Watch this. It's just perfect. It is perfect. Just look. Bang. I'm just saying, if that was me, I would have gone so pissed off. Like, imagine that was you who got hit like that. I would have been both impressed and pissed off. But, bruh, the king has his rightful crown. Bow down, Kakarot Jr. All right, sweet. I'll concede. I lost to you, Kak. I lost. Okay? Are you happy? But how many times did you lose to me, huh?
I'll get you, man. Just, I'll get you. Don't worry.
Oh, I love this! This is Humana! I love this so much!
I know Mr. Lisp made this, or Missy Lisp.
But oh my god, I love this so much!
Lisp sent me this in my DMs already. I said before that the ears make Humana look like a Pokemon ear. I love it. I absolutely love it. And you got the tail perfect. Like, if you didn't get the tail, I wouldn't have accepted it. Oh, there's your name, Liz.
But I love this so much.
Yo, guys, I'm just saying, if you don't have a Reddit, go make a Reddit just to upvote that. Legit, go make a Reddit, make this one of the most upvoted things this year. Lispy deserves that love, it's of Shivana as well, I absolutely love it. What I got for my birthday, hey, happy birthday, mate, and bruh, Sanctum Sanctorum, that looks sick. That looks absolutely sick. Let me see the notes. Dude, that looks so... Look at... Yo, it's that one-eyed monster. The one from Multiverse of Madness. Bro, that's sick. I love it. I want to know this. How long did it take you to make this? How long did it take you to make this one thing? I'm kind of curious about that. Also, you want to know what I love? I love how this one actually looks like it's flying. I know it's not actually flying because that's impossible. But in this photo, it just looks like it's actually flying. I think you can see something connected over here. One of them are connecting. But this one is a perfect angle where it looks like that thing up there is actually flying. I have made this as an Ash Ketchum farewell art. It looks really good, bro. Thanks, Trajan friends. Look, I'm going to be absolutely real. It's not that I don't like Ash, but I feel like the anime was becoming very weak after... I don't know, like, the first couple of ones, the Johto, Sinnoh, Hoenn, all of those, like, first four regions, like, the first four gens, those were really good. And then, people might differ, but the one where there was Iris, it was here and then the one where there was Serena, it was really good again. And then I don't know what happened after that. I feel like it's just kind of like when the art style changed, I stopped liking it completely. But by then, I feel like Ash already overstayed his welcome. If you ask me, yeah, Pokemon has already made a lot of things that are really good. So you got Pokemon Origins, you got Twilight Wings, you got that thing in Hisui, all of those things. There's also Pokemon Generations. Bro, there's this one Pokemon Generations episode. Hold on. Yeah, this episode. I actually can't show you any part of this episode because of copyright. RIP. Originally, I was reacting to 30 to 40 seconds of the episode, praising just about everything about it. But I will still stand. Go watch the episodes yourself. But yeah, I feel like there's just a lot of people out there that don't realize how much more Pokemon content is out there that's better than the anime with Ash. All credit to Ash. They did a phenomenal job at keeping the series going. A couple of their seasons were top tier, like nothing can beat it. Like, dude, I'll say that much. But I feel Ash should have ended a very long time ago anyway. But kudos, GGs. I'm glad that Ash got the adventure that he deserved. I'm glad that so many generations of people got to see Ash. But there is so much more that Pokemon can explore. Stop texting my girlfriend. Chill, bro. She's dating both of us. You're my boyfriend-in-law. When you're fast asleep, then all of a sudden... Imagine. And lucky last, Lloyd Post. Adorbs. How did you make these? Did you draw these? Well, is this digital art or is this like some sort of character customization through a video game? Because that looks really cool. I really like those. This is the old art that I was expecting. I like this sort of art as well because it's just classic. I really like that. But I'm curious as to how you made these. Echo Lloyd Sync and Lost. Cute. What happened there? Why'd she look like a watermelon? Alright everyone, that is it for this Reddit video. Thank you very much for watching and thank you to everyone who posts on the Reddit. If you want to be featured in a future Reddit video, make sure you join the Reddit, make sure you post stuff there, and you'll see your stuff over here. Also, I'm trying to make a theme song for the Reddit. I have somewhat of a draft for this, but I'm gonna start using it after we get to 1,000 subscribers. But anyways, that's it for me. Thank you very much for watching. Take care. See ya.